More trouble. Jonathan. That's a pretty unique hairstyle. Her hairstyle's got personality. That curl over there's got nothing on this work of nature. Oh, I must disagree, the guide says. I have nothing on such ancient beauty of the natural world. You can't possibly compare me to true beauty. He's trying. Got a top heavy for such a young age. Those are nice. Firm. Yet supple. That's my rudimentary evaluation anyway. That's a girlish kind of design. Our uniform is very popular among girls my age. To be honest, I applied for this job just so I could get to wear this.
Really?
Alright, just in case I get thrown away, thrown out of this place. Don't do this in real life, guys. This is real life. This is sexual assault. I'm calling this the hands-on part of the museum. Ed says, hey, Anna used to work here. She could know her. Come on. Those are million to one odds, Ed. Ed says, and then pretty soon everyone knows her dad hangs around that perverted weirdo. Oh, we can't. All right. May we talk to you a second? You have a question? So that's about the museum. AMM gives you an up-close view of the history of mankind's colonization of outer space and the fruits of these labors. We have over 8,000 items on display here. Some of the larger exhibits had to be temporarily disassembled in order to be brought inside. We'll be holding events next month as part of Beyond's 30th anniversary celebrations. Sound interesting, Jonathan says. That's right, they were talking about the colony's deterioration on the news. What exactly is going on? Ed says Tokugawa are the ones who stand to make all the money out of fixing the colony. They also effectively control the ISPA, who decides who gets to build colonies. Jonathan says, making the anniversary a golden opportunity for them. Pioneer. Where can we find Pioneer? Ed asks. Pioneer 10 is on display at the Space Corner. Let's go take a look. Space Corner. Must be tough being on your feet for so long. Yes, it does get quite tiring. I guess it's been a good 3 hours or so I've been standing here.
Wow.
The demands they put on you, Jonathan says. Ed says, Anna always talked about how tough this job was. How many hours you work each day? I'm here from opening to closing, so a full 9 hours.
9 hours?
They do give us breaks, of course. So what time do you get off? I'm sorry, but we're not permitted to date visitors. Ed says, I like that rule. Good to see they enforce it, too. I probably didn't need to worry about Anna when she was here after all. So that's a no? Please don't take it personally. It's one of the rules here. Ed says, you're trying to hit on a guide in a museum? She's gonna get mad if you keep it up. Ed says, I'll need to keep a closer eye on Anna in the future with guys like you out there. Make her jump? Oh boy. The second floor. Say, what's happening on the second floor? Ed asks. It looks closed off. The second floor? It's currently closed for renovation. It's being repainted and redecorated for upcoming events. I think we'll make it in time for the anniversary. The second floor is only open to the construction crew at the moment. I don't believe I've seen either of them here. They aren't featured in any of our exhibits. Policenauts photo. We have an exhibit on them here, of course. I'm sorry, but are you by any chance Policenaut Ingram? It just so happens I am. No, on second thought, I guess that couldn't be possible. I'm sorry I brought it up. Ah! I am Policenaut Ingram. Make her jump. Maybe jumping around a little would relieve some of the tension of standing? Hmm? I'm saying I bet some light activity every now and then would make all the standing a lot easier. You know, you may be right. I'll give that a try. Oh, jeez. God bless this informant for choosing this place. I do feel a little better now, actually. You know, I can't see that actually happening except in 0G, which we are not in. I imagine you do. Ed says, I should have known. What could you possibly have against this? I'm promoting physical activity. Just unbelievable, Ed says. Your whole world just revolves around this shit, doesn't it? The more you jump, the better you'll feel. Good point. I am feeling better and better. That's no surprise. I'm feeling much, much better now. Hey, how about that? I'm feeling better too. This has completely turned my day around, the guide says. What a coincidence. You know, I was about to say the exact same thing. Another jump. What do you say, huh? Actually, I'm feeling better now. Jonathan says, damn, gotta think of something else quick. So, another jump, please? I'm fine now, thank you. Alright, we're done. Do you have any other questions? Thanks, that was all we needed. You're very welcome. Come see me again if you need anything else. Well, I'm sure Jonathan will. I think we have a chance to talk to this guy, too. No? We can talk to this kid. When I grow up, the boy says, I'm gonna blow this joint and become an amphibian. I'll get to travel to home and all over space. That's interesting, Jonathan says. Kids from beyond are the opposite of us. Ed says, kids from home want to go to space. Kids from beyond want to see home. Grass is always greener on the other side. I love museums. I come here every day. Want to explore the museum together? Sorry, Jonathan says, but we've got things to do here. Well, you wouldn't know it. Talk to the old guy? I enjoy coming here. I find it soothing. The mirror. It was just us out here in those days. Were you an astronaut? Ed asks. Jonathan says, they stopped using astronaut in official lingo not long after the turn of the century. I was a mission controller. See that model? I work with the real thing. You mean the mirror? Yeah, we saw it. This really takes me back, you know? Let's leave him be, Ed says. Anyone else to talk to? Alright, let's visit the information booth. More trouble. Plant. Wow, we can't look at anything besides her. All right. That boyish kind of hair looks good on you. Oh, you think so? I've been thinking about growing it out, but maybe I won't. That's a cute haircut. That coral over there has got nothing on this work of nature. Ed says, gonna try your luck with that lion again, huh? Oh, I must disagree. I have nothing on such ancient beauty of the natural world. Jonathan says she's working off the same script as that other girl. And so are you, Jonathan. Wait, do they actually give you a list of responses like that or something? Ha ha ha, Ed says. You know, maybe dragging your ass around beyond ain't so bad after all. Thank you. You're a pretty girl. You should be a guide instead of stuck behind a desk. That's kind of you, but you have to be a certain age to be a guide. What a ridiculous policy. There is no good reason you can't be out there, too. Thank you. You know, forget this place. How's about you show me around the colony instead? Nice try, sport. It says she's a guide. That's one of the better racks I've come across since I got here. Okay, we can only talk to her. Which I'm kind of relieved. Excuse me, Ed says. How can I help you? The museum is divided into three main corners, Beyond, Moon, and Space. Here at AMM, you'll find a thorough retracting of space exploration and development from their beginnings to the present day. The theme of our exhibition is Beyond, Gateway to the Stars. We're run by the Tokugawa Group and receive the full support of the International Space Promotion Agency. Jonathan asks, Tokugawa runs this place too? Ed says, there's very little you can do on Beyond without Tokugawa. We hope to see you again for one of our anniversary events. Pioneer. Where can we find a Pioneer around here? The only Pioneer we have is Pioneer 10. We don't have Pioneers 1 through 9 or 11. And where is Pioneer 10? It says. Pioneer 10 can be found at the Space Corner.
どうやらパイオニアは一つしかないらしい。タレコミ屋の指定場所はそこだな。ああ、パイオニア15枚だ。
Juomaida is 10. We don't have Pioneer Venus 1 or 2 either. The only Pioneer we have is Pioneer 10 at the Space Corner. Good job. Must be tough being on your feet for so long. It is. We do get a break every 2 hours, but still, you're right. My legs are getting sore again. Wow. Demands they put on you. So far so good, Jonathan says. Jonathan thinks, and Ed thinks, why you do this to me, God? Why? Bet you had to do a lot of studying, huh? Yes, after all, we have to be able to talk about a wide range of subjects. Guess you could say you put your mind as well as your body to use. What time do you finish? The museum closes at 7 p.m. No, not that. I meant, when do you finish? Oh, so that's what you were thinking. Come on, man, Ed says. What do you think we came here for? I'll need to keep a closer eye, etc. When did they let you guys off? Why, are you planning to break in and steal something? Haha, you had that one coming, Ed says. I'm hurt, Ed. Genuinely hurt. Come on, man, etc. How about dinner sometime? I'd love to learn more about space from an expert. I'm sorry, but I can't. We're prohibited from having any personal interactions with visitors. It's one of the rules here. Second floor. Why don't we ask her too? Ed asks, we can't go up to the second floor, can we? Second floor is currently closed for renovation. They're redoing it for our anniversary events. No one is allowed up to the second floor until further notice. Hold your photo? I'm sorry, but I don't know these people. Haven't met either of them before. We have an ex-visitor on the Policenauts at the Beyond Corner. We don't have that particular photograph, but there are life-size figures of all five members. That's pretty cool. We gotta see that. Life-size figures? Jonathan says, hot damn. Wanna take a look, Ed says? You'll get a good laugh, I promise. Make her jump? You're saying I should jump up and down? You might be onto something. I'll give it a try. I'm just not repeating the repeat dialogue, guys. Oh, jeez. Look at that. You're a natural. I do feel a little better now, actually. Yeah, I thought you'd enjoy it. Kojima's a real pervert, you know that? Wow, this actually works. Jonathan says, you took the words out of my mouth. Something the matter? Have you been staring at my breasts while I've been jumping? Jonathan thinks, damn it, note to self, get a pair of sunglasses for this. No, not at all. I was just admiring your posture despite that weight you have to carry. You, sir, disgust me. Why don't you try jumping again? Well, I can scratch her off the list. Is Is there something else you'd like to hear about? That'll be all, thank you. Jonathan, he is worse than Ingram. I mean, worse than Ingram. Worse than Gillian. Okay, so we can go to... Let's go... This is our destination, but we want to check out the life-size replicas of the Beyond people. Not Beyond people. The, Policenauts, the name of the game.
ここがビヨンド関連の展示コーナーだ。あ、エド、俺たちポリスノーツの人形が並んでるぞ。
うん。
さっきのコンパニオンが言った通りだろ。そういえばスペースプレーンのスチュワーデスも言ってたな。ここはビヨンドの観光地中でもポピュラーだからな。
この若さで歴史上の人物とは。
そう言うな。俺たちも宇宙開発に少しは貢献したんだ。光栄じゃないか。うん、
少しはか。
This is a small monument built in honor of the Policenauts. It's even got our autographs on it. So it does. Makes you feel kind of stupid, don't it? We're like some Hollywood stars.
このビヨンドの位置が記されているマップだ。
ラグランジュポイントの L5。
そう、この地球と月の重力バランスの均衡位置にコロニーは浮かんでいる。
ニュースで見たんだが、このコロニーも傷んできてるんだろ。
もう30年も経つからな。
疑問に思うんだが、なぜこのタイプのコロニーは作られないんだ。
これには技術的な問題もあるだろうが、コロニーの建築業者が絡んでいるんだ。
政治的な問題？
まさに今、コロニー建設のシェアは徳川建設が独占している。もともと徳川のコロニー技術はトーラス型のものだ。ここのオニール型は欧米の技術。
つまり癒着。徳川がオニール型を排除した。
そうだろうな。徳川が自社のトーラス型を売り込んだ結果だろう。もちろん大型オニールコロニーの欠陥も発見された上でのことだ。
ビヨンドがオニール型の欠陥を自ら証明した。
そこへうまく徳川が介入したんだ。
道理でコロニー老朽化をバンバン宣伝してるわけだ。しかしこのコロニーを作った欧米企業も黙っちゃいないだろう。コロニー建設といえばオリンピックより儲かる。
それだけではない。オニール型のコロニーを推し進めていた欧米企業もコロニーの部品を徳川に依存していたからなんだ。
徳川抜きではコロニーは作れない。
そういうことだ。
徳川ビルの女の子がトーラス型のことを徳川型とか言ってたな。
Yep. It's a diagram showing Beyond's position.
ビヨンドの模型だ。俺たちが今いるコロニーのな。
世界で最初で最後のシリンダー型コロニ
ー。 You could call this place home for Beyonds. That diagram is a good visual aid. Johnson says you made a model of it for me before. Yeah, I did. Heh, I remember. I still got it, Johnson says. It's sitting in my office. Hey, glad to hear that, man. That's the only model I ever built. Really? Not bad, huh? So that explains it. This is a replica of the Yuri, the forerunner to the modern EMPS. Its emphasis was on mechanical work outside the colony, so its armor's thin and it's only lightly equipped. Totally different setup from today, Jonathan says. Ed says it was hailed as the successor to NASA's MMU. Hard to imagine this is where combat EMPS evolved from, huh? This is what I had my accident in. Nearly sent me on a one-way trip to nowhere. And this is the thing he was stuck in. Well, it's gotta be smaller, right?
これがさっき見た、ユーリーが積載していた脱出用ポッドのサバイバルボールだ。コールドスリープの機能も搭載している。 実物はもう少し大きいがな。
俺はこの中で30年間も宇宙をさまよっていたんだ。そのために宇宙不適応者になった。
うん、ジョナサンの生命を30年間維持し続けたんだ。よくできたカプセルだよ。
コールドスリープとしてはまさに実験段階だった。救出された時は寝たきり老人と変わらなかった。
今じゃ筋肉の低下もあまりない。
俺は1年以上も歩けなかった。
わお。
クマの冬眠の研究の成果だ。
クマ？
人間は筋肉を使わなければ3日で衰える。しかしクマは冬眠中半年以上も筋肉を維持できるんだ。
うん、
なるほど。クマの方が宇宙飛行士に向いてるようだ。
アストロベア、
今やこのコールドスリープをクマの冬眠と呼んでいる。
It's a survival ball, the escape capsule you used. A time machine that brought me 25 years into the future. Is there another model beyond that? Is that part of the same thing? That's the same thing. I can't stand the sight of this thing. You had that survival ball with you too. Good thing I did. Yeah, after all, the Yuri didn't have its own life pod. You made me take it, just in case, you said. The Yuri by itself would have only kept you alive for 3 days. This is me in my younger days. I'd never recognize you. Come on, I hate it when people say shit about my age. These are really well done, Jonathan says. They're like our doppelgangers. We got the best in the business on these. They were given every piece of data they had on us. Body measurements, hair samples, everything. Jonathan says they knew us better than we know ourselves. I remember them going over our bodies with a fine-tooth comb when we applied for the astronauts, it says. Or policenauts, rather. I hear they're going to replace these with animatronic robots soon. They're going to have us moving around like idiots? Using hydraulics and air pressure, yeah, and we'll even talk. The same Japanese company that made those animatronic dinosaurs is going to make them. You know the ones I mean, right? Jonathan asks, who'll decide how we move? They've already got all the necessary data. They're working with the ISPA on them. They'll end up being some live-action show, almost indistinguishable from the real us. Damn. It's my figure. They did an amazing job with these, Jonathan says. It's scary. Is this some kind of ladder to something? Okay, let's look at it. Okay, Jonathan Ingram. This is your figure. I think it's slightly better looking. Look at how they got me smiling. I never smile like this. God damn it. Minor details aside, they did a good job on these. It's a figure of Tokugawa. Sometimes I forget he used to be one of us. Jonathan says now he's practically some kind of god. He knows what he's doing. He's used a police knot to promote the group a number of times in the past. It's a figure of Salvatore. He looks a little big for some reason. Jonathan says, well, he's the kind of guy who seems smaller than he actually is. Yeah, it's true. Sal makes some mistakes in his life, just like us. Ended up better off than us. At least he's got a decent job. It's a figure of Gates. Of the five of us, he was most likely to end up chief, Jonathan says. Yeah, now he's my boss. Alright, I guess we're done in here. Before we go to the space corner, let's head to the moon corner.
ここはアポロ計画を中心に月面関係が展示されているコーナーだ。
月面のセットがそのまま再現されてる。
That's Surveyor, the lunar probe that was used to scout for landing sites for the Apollo missions. Jonathan says Surveyor 1 got there several years before the first humans arrived. Ed says the Surveyor program ended with Surveyor 7, 18 months before the first manned mission. A replica of Surveyor 1. That's a lunar roving module that was taken aboard Apollos 15, 16, and 17. It was electric-powered with a top speed of 14 kilometers an hour on a flat surface. Jonathan says, kind of like an EMPS for the guys back then. part of it too, yeah. This is the so-called Genesis rock that Apollo 11 brought back from the moon. It's not as special now as it was back then, of course. Is this the real thing? Yeah, moon rocks are a dime a dozen now, but I suppose you could call this a first edition moon rock. Jonathan says, I saw them selling them at the spaceport in OLA. That just sucks. All that was special right out of them. Ed says, Lunar regolith was once heavily sought after for experiments, since there was so little available then. Jonathan says, that all changed with the 21st century. Ed says, people would even go to the trouble of making their own regolith. That's how valuable it was. This was the first moon rock ever brought back to home. I mean, they're selling... Is that the magic loss or something? Jonathan says, I mean, they're selling moon rocks at gift shops like cheap souvenirs. That's part of the Apollo Lunar Surface Experiments package that was deployed on the moon by Apollos 12, 14, 15, 16, and 17. This is an ALSEP device sensitive to lunar surface movement, a seismometer, basically. Jonathan says, I heard that there are stores that fix up this kind of old equipment and sell it. From the Apollo era. This is the lunar module's ladder. Astronaut Armstrong's famous words are broadcast as he stepped down from the ninth rung onto the lunar surface. Jonathan says, who knows, if that bottom rung had been a little higher, his words might have been different. This is the Eagle's ladder. It's the American flag. The Apollo astronauts planted one on the surface after each landing. When you think about it, planting a national flag in space like that does seem pretty ridiculous, even if it was smack in the middle of the space race. That was back when America was still a superpower, Ed says. She needed a way to flexing her muscle. Space was dominated by a handful of countries in those days. Ed says, yeah, now business dominates it. It's the Stars and Stripes. It was planted on the lunar surface after each Apollo landing. What's this foil for? It was to provide protection from the heat. It's aluminized Kapton foil used for insulation. This is a replica of Apollo 11's lunar module, the Eagle. Jonathan says, July 20th, 1969. Who could ever forget that day? Ed says, the ascent module was recovered and brought back to home, but the descent module is still out there. The Saturn rocket outside is the same as the one that launched the Apollo missions. The only thing left is these astronauts. That's the lunar EVA suit used during the Apollo program. You could call this the Yuri of spacesuits. Look at the stuff they had to wear back then. Must have weighed a ton. Jonathan says, today's hard suits look much easier to move in. It's amazing how seeing one spacesuit can take you so far back in time. That's a life support device on his back. Jonathan says, you'd be like a hunchback with this on. Probably couldn't even bend over. Ed says, it contains things like communications equipment, a telemetry device. Sorry guys, and its own power supply. Another second-generation lunar EVA suit. Jonathan says, I bet pretty soon they'll have these turned into robots, huh? Yeah, more of an attraction than an exhibit. You could call this the Yuri of spacesuits. Yes, right. Okay, well, the only place to go is the Space Corner. We're supposed to meet this supposed informant. But we're going to do that next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.